The answer was a Māori revolution in the art of war. Ohaeawai had two fences and a firing trench right around it. Warriors reloaded while standing safely in the bottom of the trench, then stepped up to fire through the gap in the fences. Fence and trench were protection from the guns and bayonets of a storming party. The trenches were laid out unevenly to bring attackers under fire from two directions at once. The outermost fence, the pekarangi, was not intended to block a storming party, but to slow them up to be shot. It could be pulled down or clambered over, but it took time, which the defenders used to shoot, reload, and shoot again. Basically, the pekarangi had the same function as barbed wire on more recent battlefields.
The whole front of the pa flashed fire. Guns flashed from the foot of the stockade and from loopholes higher up. Smoke half hiding the pa from us. Yells and cheers and men falling all around. Not a single Maori could we see. They were all safely hidden. What could we do?
Covered passages into the interior of the pa meant that Kawiti could quickly and safely concentrate his few men at threatened points, in effect multiplying their numbers. But he knew he could only do this if they survived the initial bombardment. So he pocked the inside of Ohaeawai with deep pits and underground caverns, probably the world's first anti-artillery bunkers. These bunkers blunted the bombardment. The trenches blunted the assault.